This is the solution to quiz one. Okay, so then part A is saying that what we need to do is solve the derivative of f at x equal to negative 4 for x. So that's a translation of those instructions. Okay, so let's compute the derivative. The derivative is 4x plus 8. And we want to solve 4x plus 8 equal to negative 4. So negative 4 is 4x plus 8. Subtract 8 from both sides. So negative 12 is 4x. And then divide by 4. So negative 3 is x. Okay, so that's the x value. Now find the equation of the tangent line. Okay. So, we already know that the slope that we're looking for is m equal to negative 4. So, the slope of the tangent line is negative 4. What we really need to compute next is the point. We know that the x value of the point is negative 3, and the y value will be whatever you get when you plug in negative 3, the x value. So then plugging that in with the calculator into the original function, that's 2 times negative 3 squared plus 8 times negative 3 plus 9. So that happens to be 3. So therefore the equation is y minus y0 is m multiplied by x minus x0. So now we just have to plug in all the things that we know. So y minus 3 is negative 4 times x minus negative 3. Okay, so then simplifying this, y minus 3 is negative 4 times x plus 3, because that's x minus negative 3. Distribute the negative 4. So y minus 3 is negative 4 x minus 12, and then add 3 to both sides, so y is negative 4x, and then add 3 to both sides, minus 9. Okay, question 2, find the slope of the secant line. Okay, so what's requested here is that we want to compute the slope is the change in y over the change in x, which is f of 5 minus f of 2 divided by 5 minus 2. The change in y divided by the change in x. So let's calculate these individually. F of 5, plugging in 5, that'd be negative 5 cubed plus 5 times 5 plus 2. That's negative 98. F of 2 is negative 2 cubed plus 5 times 2 plus 2, so that'd be 4. And therefore, the change in y is negative 98 minus 4, which is negative 102. And the change in x, 5 minus 2, that's 3. And therefore, the answer is change in y divided by change in x equal to negative 102 over 3, which is negative, 34? Yes. Find the equation of the secant line. Okay. So we already know the slope of the line that we want. So the slope is m equal to negative 34. The point, well, we actually already know 2 points on the line. We know that one of the points is 2 comma 4, and we know another point is 5 comma negative 98. And either of those points will work. I'll use this one because these numbers are smaller. But you could just as well use the other one. The equation then is y minus y0 is m x minus x0, and we just plug in all the bits. So y minus 4 is negative 34 times x minus 2. So y minus 4 is negative 34x plus 68. And then adding 4 to both sides, we obtain y equal to negative 34x plus 72. And the last question. Find the value of the parameter a such that the slope of the tangent line at x equal 2 is 1326. So to translate this into plain language, we want to solve f prime, the derivative, evaluated at 2 equal to 1, 3, 2, 6 for the parameter a. Okay, so in the first place we'll need the derivative. That is 3a x squared plus 12x plus 5, and then the derivative evaluated at 2, well, that would be 3a times 4, because that's 2 squared, and then plus 24 plus 5, so simplifying the derivative evaluated at 2 is 12a plus 24 plus 5, so plus 29. And now we want to solve this equal to 1326. So 1, 3, 2, 6 equal 12a plus 29. Subtract 29 from both sides. So 1, 2, 9, 7 is equal to 12a. And therefore, 1, 2, 9, 7 over 12 is a. So, let's see, can that fraction be simplified at all? Well, 12 is divisible by 3 and 4. That's not divisible by 4. But is it divisible by 3? So 1 plus 2 is 3 plus 9 is 12, plus 7 is 19, which is not divisible by 3, so that's the simplest answer.